that she had to leave.
But you believed on that call that she sounded genuinely upset?
Crying, sniffling, I mean, upset.
Because the truth, he now knows, was much worse. And it's left him wondering whether he ever really knew who Alix was.
Who is Alix Tichelman? Right? Who is she?
Alix spent her early teens in an Atlanta suburb where she played sports and won writing awards.
Her friends say that she's very smart, very deep.
But also very troubled.
Her experiences with boys were not always happy ones. And she had eating disorders. She was taking drugs.
Desperate, her parents went looking for help and located a school that they thought would give her special attention.
So they found this place called the Hyde School in Maine. I think it was like $50,000 a year for that.
We are in Maine, en route to Hyde.
10 years ago, Megan was a student here.
I can feel like pressure in my chest. It's nerve-wracking.
She asked us not to use her last name, but agreed to travel back to the Hyde School campus.
I want people to see this very pivotal part of her life that I feel probably affected her at a very huge point in her development, why she is who she is.
So do you remember when you first met Alix? Do you happen to remember the very first time you saw her?
100%. She was gorgeous and she was very awkward.
The cute blonde girl next door was long gone.
She barely ate. She was very skinny. She was real thin. She was emotionally kind of closed off.
I think the big question then is why? What had happened to her?
I don't know the truth to that. She never really told me there was a specific catalyst.
But Megan says Alix did hint at some traumatic events.
We talked about the fact that we had issues trusting men. We had become numb to a lot of things.
Alix had started cutting herself. This is a photo of Alix, her then bunkmate, put in a scrapbook. It reads, "Psycho Roomie." Look at the cuts on her arm.
Alix Tichelman was actually the first person that I met who did that.
Ashley Kent lived in Alix's dorm.
She came to the school with the scars. She had already etched things into her arm, and she had already made this image of herself as this, like, devil person. Like, that's how she dressed, kind of like devil worshiper.
But was that really who Alix was?
She was actually a really nice girl. It was very much like a front that she was putting on, an image.
Megan noticed it too.
Once you bypass those walls, she was just a normal girl who was scared.
And what was she scared of?
I think herself, honestly. I mean, we didn't know who we were. We had resorted to things that, you know, not every person chooses. We had been in trouble.
And at Hyde, it seemed Alix was always in trouble. Megan says they punished her.
You're forced to do manual labor, physical labor. They basically tell you what you can and can't do.
This is the area, Megan says, where she and Alix were forced to build a road.
We hoed it, each person, and we weeded it, and then they made us cart like wheelbarrows, like huge wheelbarrows full of rocks up and spread them, so we basically built a dirt road on campus.
Ashley remembers one night waking up to Alix screaming. What happened sounds like a scene out of a Stephen King movie.
She like kind of walked down the halls and like was cutting herself really late at night.
She began just to hurt herself because that's what she thought she deserved.
When it didn't work out at Hyde, Alix's parents tried other schools, but the worst was still to come.
She talked about taking heroin when she was in her teens.